20 minutes after the hour, here's what's coming up. A huge breakthrough in the fight against cancer, like a treatment that's outperforming chemo. And it's about to get even better. We'll take a look at three new advances this year.
25 minutes now after the hour. 2015 has seen some major groundbreaking cancer discoveries, the most in decades, with a treatment that's outperforming even chemo. Get this. Here to explain the three new advances you need to know is Dr. Johanna Bendell from the Sarah Cannon Research Institute. Dr. Bendell, welcome back.
Thank you so much.
So much is happening positive against cancer, and I can't believe it's happening in our lifetime. First off, replacing chemo with immunotherapy?
Yes, this is so exciting. This is a concept we've been doing research on for years and years, trying to get the body itself to attack the cancer. All of us at any time have cancer in our bodies, but the immune system will attack it. But as cancers start to grow, they hide themselves from the immune system. And we found a way to stop them from hiding from the immune system.
So you're trying to outsmart them. You're having a lot of success with this. It is a shot rather than a treatment that's debilitating, correct?
Correct. Most of my patients that are on immunotherapies who have had chemotherapy say, are you actually giving me treatment? Because even though there are side effects, much less than chemotherapy.
So when you talk about getting your system to attack the cancer, which you want out, to, for example, if your system is stronger than mine, might you have more success since humans are so different in terms of our resistance?
Humans are definitely different, but certainly when that immune system finds a target, it will go after it full force.
And what kind of price are we talking about?
They are expensive. The ones that have been approved recently are showing a cost difference, but we're also talking about improvement potentially in years of survival for patients with cancer.
So if my doctor says, we're going to give you chemo and you have cancer, should I say I'm at the wrong doctor? Do I have to bring up to the doctor this immunotherapy that I saw on Fox and Friends, or will they know this?
Most of the cancer doctors will know about this. We have agents that are FDA approved, but it never hurts to ask.
Okay, great. Now, targeted therapies, how does that differ?
So this is different in that we're starting more and more to look at individual tumors and look at mutations in those tumors that make them function as cancers. And so what we can do is have medicines that specifically attack those abnormalities in the cancer cells and kill the cancer.
So sometimes you can have pills that go after lung cancer.
Yes. Yes. That's one of the most famous ones. They're called ALK inhibitors, and they're pills that attack the lung cancer and widely improve survival.
So, doctor, also you have blood-based cancer therapies that are giving us a reason to feel encouraged.
Yes. The leukemias and lymphomas, patients with those types of treatments or those types of cancers have amazing new treatments that are available, both using the immune system and targeted therapies to cure more patients.
Do you sense that there's pressure on the pharmaceutical companies now to bring down the prices into a way in which the consumer can afford and the insurance companies will pay?
There's definitely pressure that's happening, but we also have to think of the money it costs to develop these drugs. And so there's a happy medium somewhere there. And I think that the government and I think that pharmaceutical companies will work together because in the end, it's the patient that matters.
You know, there's a sense that sometimes the best treatment is in the major cities. Well, you know, you have a cancer. We're going to get you out of Iowa, we're going to pull you out of Idaho, we're going to bring you to New York City. Is that still the case?
Not necessarily. There's a lot of different research mechanisms that are going on where we can bring those trials to the patients in their hometowns.
All right, so we brought you good news 2 days in a row about cancer and the encouraging word. It has not been that case for the longest time. Dr. Johanna Bendell, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
All right, great news. Meal, 2 minutes before the bottom of the hour. Coming up straight ahead.